Hello, YouTube. It is a brand new kind of me. Today is October 8th, 2016. I had the gastric sleeve on Monday, October 3rd, so it's been five days. I'm sorry that I wasn't able to do daily updates. However, I promise you did not want to see or hear from me the first couple days that I was home. I was discharged from the hospital on Wednesday, even though my surgeon really did want to keep me an extra day because my white blood cells were high. And then after they retested, my white blood cells were okay, but my hemoglobin level was low. So apparently, I guess it just means I wasn't producing enough blood, probably due to dehydration. But they allowed me to go home as long as I promised to go and get blood work done the following day. So I did that. And I haven't heard anything from the doctor's office since then, but I'm feeling pretty good. The biggest challenge being home, you know, truthfully, the pain isn't that bad. It's just a new feeling of what, you can see my kitty in the background. It's just a new feeling of what swallowing is like. Before I used to drink tons of water and, you know, chug water, you know, just like chug water a little, you know, a bottle at a time. And then I always made sure I got my water in. But now with the surgery, and I'm sure especially since my stomach is still swollen, I can't get much water in. And when I swallow, it's, I believe is what they call a spasm. So they talked about spasms and how your stomach will kind of spasm sometimes. I do have medication that I'm taking for that now that I know that that's what the feeling was, but it basically just felt like the hole was too small for water to fit through, and I would take a gulp or even try to take a smaller sip, but there would just be this weird discomfort. The doctor's office did send me home with these 1 ounce little medicine cups. I had a stack of them, and they recommended, you know, filling these up with your fluid and drinking one of these. I've heard some people say one an hour. Some people are saying one every 15 minutes. I have better luck for whatever reason filling it up and drinking little sips, but continual little sips, like drink a little, let it go down, drink a little bit down. And I haven't been really doing it on the hour. So today's the first day that I'm drinking out of a regular mug. I got my, I don't know if you can see it, my diluted pomegranate juice. Right now it's just anything that I can, any fluids that I can get in me. Diluted juice was on the list as an okay item. So right now I'm on full clear, full liquids, which would be like your creamy soups, cream of wheat, low-fat yogurt, and things like that. They want me to add protein powder to everything that doesn't have enough protein in it. So that's been a challenge. But I did that today for lunch. I added some protein powder to my yogurt, and I could only get about 2 ounces in. I don't know. I mean, I guess a little protein is better than no protein at this point, and we're just taking it day by day. So right now at this point, I am just checking in to say that, you know, it is getting better. The first few days were kind of rough. I have not been taking any pain medication. They did send me home with some, but when I was in the hospital, I was very nauseous when I was given the pain meds. So I wanted to try and stay away from that because it was kind of defeated the purpose, because throwing up hurts so bad. That's the only time I was really, well, two times I was in pain were really the times that I was throwing up and the times that I was trying to lift myself out of the bed, which that is getting better. I feel like those muscles are regaining some of their strength, and, I'm not really having a lot of pain from the incision sites either. So, overall today was a really good day. I expect everything to kind of go uphill from here. Smooth sailing, and I'll try to keep you updated more often. Just keep in mind, anyone that is, you know, taking this journey on, that every journey is different, and I'm following a support group on Facebook, and it's, you know, it's amazing how many people react to this surgery differently. So this is just my journey and how it's been for me. You may not have the nausea or the spasms, but I do have to say that the medicine they give me for the spasms, that I was told I could take it as needed. And when I finally realized that that was the feeling, because it's like this feeling like right where your esophagus meets your stomach, or wherever, you know, it's like where that hole is, it was just too small, and then my stomach would like almost do like a hiccup is the only way I can explain it. So after I started taking the spasm medication on a regular basis 4 times a day, I haven't really had much of that occasionally, but I think that might even have to do with trying to take too much in. If I try to do more than like 2 ounces at a time, it'll do that. So eventually I should be able to hold about 4 ounces of food, but I imagine that'll take some more time before the swelling goes down completely. So it's a brand new kind of me. I am really excited about the journey and what this weight loss is going to look like, and I will keep you posted. So thank you for watching. If you like what you see, please make sure that you like the video, comment below, and you can subscribe to this channel. So it's a brand new kind of me signing off. Have a great day.